Hello, welcome to StatLearn Tech. So this is the introduction video of the latest tutorial series on Python. So let's start with the content. First line says that Python is a programming language. Well, everybody knows that, but let's understand it in this way. What's a programming language? Well, a one-line answer is, it's a tool to give instruction to the computer to do certain tasks, right? So here throughout this tutorial series, we will understand what are the instructions which are available in Python to do certain required tasks. Okay, so Python was created by Guy de Von Rossum in 1991, and its current stable release or current stable version as per 16th March 2021, the day this video will be recorded and uploaded, is 3.9.2, okay, 3.9.2. Okay, so now let's understand the properties of Python. So here I have listed like some 8 properties of Python, and we will understand it point by point. Okay, so first is that it's a high level language. Now what's a high level language is? See, when you write a code in Python, your computer cannot understand it directly. Okay, any code written in such a language which your computer cannot understand directly is a high level language. So similarly, Python is a high level language. Its code cannot be understood by your computer directly. It needs a compiler or an interpreter to be converted to such a code which your computer can understand, right? So what does a Python use? It uses an interpreter. Okay, so that is why it is called interpreted language. Now we will be dedicating a separate video to compiler versus interpreter and why is Python an interpreted language. So for now you can just understand it like in interpreter your code is executed line by line, and in compiler your whole code is firstly converted into bytecode and then it is read line by line by your system. Okay, so next point is dynamically typed. So what's dynamically typed is, see, when you define a variable in Python, its type is not fixed. Right, we have lots and lots of data type in every language, mainly in famous languages like Java or C or C++. You will see that when you create a variable, you create it like defining the data type, defining the variable name, and then telling it's a value. But in Python, you just need to create a variable name and its value is enough. You don't need to specify its data type. It will be dynamically decided according to the value associated with it. Okay. So next point is ease of code readability. Well, ease of code readability, I can say it like this. Suppose you have same kind of code, means suppose you have a multiplication code written in Java and written in Python and written in C, written in C++, lots and lots of language. When a newbie or someone who doesn't know programming see that code, so the probability of him understanding the code of Python is more as compared to other languages, because the code is written in such a way and such a structured way that it's really easy to understand. Okay, so next point is automatic garbage collection. Well, automatic garbage collection means whenever you define a variable in a language, now let's not just understand it with Python. Python is automatic garbage collection type. Many languages we need to collect the garbage manually, right? So what is garbage collection is, when you create a variable, it has a reference. The variable name refers to the variable's value. Okay, so when there are no more references left to the value, what should happen is its memory should get free, right? So this freeing of memory is done in Python automatically. You don't need to worry about that. So this is the automatic garbage collection thing. Next is it supports one of the best programming aspect, that is object oriented aspect. So Python, in Python you can use object oriented programming aspect and its properties like abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, these kind of things are available in Python. Well, we will talk deeply about this later in the section. Okay, so next thing is the platform independency. See, Python is a platform independent language. It means that if you compile a code or create a code in Windows operating system, you compile your code. Now, you don't need to worry that this particular code will worry in other operating system or not. It will, right? Because the program is platform independent. It doesn't depend upon the operating system it is written on. Okay. ओके, तो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज जनरल पर्पस। वेल, पाइथन इज अ जनरल पर्पस लैंग्वेज। इट मीन्स दैट इट्स एप्लीकेशंस आर नॉट इन अ पर्टिकुलर डोमेन बट कुड बी यूज इन मल्टीपल डोमेन्स। लाइक इट कुड बी यूज इन वेब डेवलपमेंट, इट कुड बी यूज इन डेस्कटॉप एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट, इट कैन बी यूज इन मशीन लर्निंग एप्लीकेशंस, इमेज प्रोसेसिंग टू क्रिएट टेस्ट फ्रेमवर्क्स, एंड देर आर मैनी मैनी मोर थिंग्स इन विच वी कैन यूज पाइथन। सो दैट इज वाई वी से दैट पाइथन इज अ जनरल पर्पस लैंग्वेज। ओके, तो दिस इज द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू पाइथन लैंग्वेज। आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट्स रियली ग्रेट टू लर्न पाइथन, एटलीस्ट इन टूडेज एरा, इन 21st सेंचुरी यू शुड नो पाइथन इफ यू आर इन प्रोग्रामिंग वर्ल्ड। सो वी विल गो डीप डाउन दिस सीरीज, वी विल अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग इन पाइथन। सो जस्ट स्टे विद द सीरीज। इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो, जस्ट लाइक द वीडियो ऑन यूट्यूब एज वेल, एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल सो दैट यू आर गेटिंग द एक्सेस टू दिस वीडियोज़।